Good evening, everybody. Tom DeMott from Coalition Preserve Community. I also live right on the southern end of where Columbia plans to expand, and we've been feeling it for the last few years already. Whether you have a threat of eminent domain or eminent domain implemented, the effects for the developer, that is Columbia, are positive for them and negative for us. The last time we were in this hall for a hearing, it was when Borough President Stringer decided to hold a little a hearing during the Euler process. And what he did was he cut a deal with Bollinger and Company even before the hearing, came here, listened to people all night. Well, not everybody, because he wouldn't let Mirabel speak toward the end. Listened to everybody all night, and he'd already come to his decision. Now, I think that what we're seeing from this letter from the Empire State Development Corporation here, which is a letter that was sent to the residents, it's called a legal notice that was sent to the residents and the owners in the actual expansion area, I think we're seeing the same kind of biases in the language that they use in this for Columbia, which almost renders this night here yet another sham like that hearing that Borough President Stringer had. But we're all here, we're trying again to make our voices heard in the face of a process which truly is corrupt, truly is a racist process, and truly is one that is dedicated toward the powerful and against the working class and minority communities. I'm gonna point out some of the biases in the language. And but first, I just want to say, look, you know, President Bollinger gets up here, and Kazan has said it before that. It constantly talking about all these meetings that they hold, and countless speakers from our, from us have already said, well, listen, you know, if they're so interested in listening to communication and listening to what we have to say, then why the hell don't they pay attention? Every single one of these meetings, unanimously, people have said no to eminent domain. It is unfair. It is, probably unconstitutional the way they're doing it. And it's a good thing that we have some really strong and principled guys, even though Columbia tried to drag Nick Sprayragon's name through the mud any number of ways. He's the one who did the environmental suit, you know, to stand up against the bathtub issues and these biotech labs and some of these other major issues. And he's the one who has been standing strong and saying that he's going to stand up for eminent domain and fight this thing. And, you know, it's really funny that Columbia tries to, you know, to denigrate the people who are out here and trying to stand up for people's rights. Anyways, I think Bollinger really ought to listen to what people say at these meetings rather than just hold them and then, you know, take a cynical approach. But again, the point here is that this use of eminent domain, it's part of the all or nothing concept that Bollinger has. It's in the Board of Trustees of Columbia. It's part of that idea that you use threats and you take everything and then you figure out what you're going to do with the property later on. Because I mean, Columbia does not know what they're going to do with that 17 acres. I mean, they constantly say, well, we're not sure about this, we're not sure about that, and all the rest. But if you can get a piece of prime real estate and have the state and the governor's approval to hand it over to you and take it away from people who are paying taxes, well, shit, you might as well go for the whole ball of wax. One of the first phrases that they use is, this is the Empire State Development Corporation, is, and they use this as if it's just, you know, the words that we all would accept, eliminate an underutilized substandard urban landscape. Well, damn, that's our home, A, and B, anybody who's looked at what's been cooking, you know, for the last 15 years in that area can see that the businesses are all, they all got all ideas to expand. They've expanded. They got the rug pulled out from under them. There's restaurants cropping up. There's clubs cropping up. There's all kinds of stuff. There's a whole 197A community plan out there with ideas. You know, if, as someone mentioned earlier, the market forces were let free in this thing and ESDC did not use eminent domain, well, you surely would see the kind of a vital neighborhood that only Harlem could create, you know, continue to flower. But of course, Columbia wants to use this blight justification. How can you possibly use the word blight to describe that neighborhood. It's just so lively. And then you look at the at Nick's business, at Ann's businesses, at what's going on with Floridita. If you look, even before this eminent domain process has been cooked up, go look at the way Columbia is digging up the sewers and everything. That's affecting, for example, Floridita. You know, that's affecting their business. The gas station. Ever tried to get a gallon of gas there? Now you got to land in a helicopter to get to the pumps. It's basically you've got a situation where Patterson and the elected officials. No, I'm not going to conclude because I have some more to say. All right. Well, let me wrap up. Well, you said that you would cut a little break for people who are representing an organization. I represent an organization that's been working for 5 years on this. So could you give me a little bit of time? I'll be reasonable. I'll be reasonable. It's funny, the minute I mentioned my good friend David Patterson, that now all of a sudden some more aiding and abetting and bullying of this theft and eviction stuff is coming from ESDC. They also say they want to create new stable jobs. Damn, we got stable jobs in this neighborhood. They say that thereby they want to help preserve Columbia's position as the seventh largest private employer. What, are we in the business here to accept eminent domain so Columbia can maintain some job ranking in the New York in New York City? Who cares about whether they're seventh or tenth? They're evicting people. They're ruining our neighborhood. They also say they want to expand housing in the proximity of the housing site. Well, we got seven buildings that we worked on for the last 20 years through HPD to develop them as low-income affordable housing. Those people want to stay. Why can't they stay? We don't need them to develop some other housing outside. We'll develop that too, but we don't need you to do it there. They all finally, they say they want to enliven 125th Street. This is ESDC saying this in terms of their objective and unbiased letter here, legal notice. Help draw residents to the West Harlem Pier Park. That's what the use of eminent domain and supporting Columbus. Now, we don't need anybody to help draw us to that park. We've been waiting for that park and fighting for that park for 20 years. We don't need Columbia University to be helping draw the people in or eminent domain. Elected officials, okay. All right, so this final thing where it says ESDC would not use eminent domain power to acquire the seven residential properties and the project site while they remain occupied by residential tenants. Look, they're using it already. They're using it against the businesses, they're using it against the owners, they're using it against the residents, and they're using it against all us in the community who are facing that 5,000 people displacement that Columbia says in their environmental impact, which is also clearly biased, that's going to happen. Thank you. I'm sorry to ruin up my time.